In the show, Bryan Alvarez here, Wrestling Observer Live. Mike Sempervivi, also WrestlingObserver.com. James Harris, best known for his run in WWE at Memphis as Kamala, has passed away at 70. Jerry Lawler was among the first to report his death. WWE has confirmed the news. Harris had suffered a number of health issues in recent years, including having both legs amputated due to high blood pressure and diabetes. ESPN reporter Jason King wrote that Kamala's wife said he had tested positive for COVID-19 on Wednesday. Spoke with Kamala's wife. He tested positive Wednesday for COVID, which he likely contracted from one of his numerous weekly visits to the dialysis center. Was hospitalized Wednesday night and seemed fine and in good spirits this morning. Went into cardiac arrest and passed this afternoon. Started wrestling in 1978 under the name Sugar Bear Harris. Wasn't until his run in Memphis territory in 1982 where he debuted the Kamala, the Ugandan headhunter gimmick. Made appearances in WWE in 1984, then in 86 and 87. It was there that Kim Chi was designated as his manager. Faced Hulk Hogan on multiple occasions for the WWE title. Another stint in Memphis, returned to WWE in 92 with Harvey Whippleman. Had a feud with The Undertaker, turned face, abandoned Whippleman and Kim Chi for Reverend Slick, who managed Kamala until he left WWE towards the end of 93. Appeared sporadically throughout the 90s and 2000s in WCW, Memphis, later the WWE, one of his high-profile matches being a match against Umaga on a 2006 episode of Raw. So I started watching wrestling around 87, 88, and was watching it regularly from that point forward. And when I was young, I just remembered Kamala having a goofy gimmick, and the matches weren't very good, and he pinned guys, or he tried to pin them when they were on their stomach. That was like all of my memories of Kamala. So then, of course, we went back and we started watching the 1992 Superstars shows. Went back and we've been watching the Saturday night's main event shows in the 80s, and I have watched Kamala through new eyes. Now, I'm not going to sit here and tell you that Kamala was a great worker, okay? But Kamala was so much better than I remembered. He didn't have great matches because he had a gimmick that was not required to have great matches, nor from about 1988 on were you even required to have anything resembling a great match in WWF. You just went in there, you played your gimmick. The match was a gimmick, if you had a gimmick character, blah, 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 blah. But this guy could move, and he was athletic, and he was flexible. It was so much better than I remembered. Now, what was so much worse than I remembered, if you go back and you watch those Kamala interviews in WWF, they're so bad. Like, I don't even know if it's like an insult to call them racist to things that were actually, it's just so bad. It's so bad when you go back and watch it. Oh Lord. But you know, in the ring, I mean, he was so great at being Kamala. Like he's, you don't want to necessarily mention him in the same breath as an Undertaker, but I want to mention him in the same breath as The Undertaker because The Undertaker was a guy, Mark Calloway. He was given a gimmick during an era where everyone had a dumb gimmick. And his gimmick was he was a dead guy that did magic, okay? How different was The Undertaker from Papa Shango? Not that much different. But you know what? Mark Calloway made that gimmick work for 30 years. The greatest gimmick in the history, probably of all of pro wrestling, The Undertaker. If you would have given that gimmick to anybody else, would The Undertaker, whoever that person is, would that have been a legendary character 30 years later? There's virtually no chance. We saw fake Undertakers. We saw fake Kanes. Kane's another one. Like, if you would have given that gimmick to anybody else, would Kane have been as successful as he ended up being? Probably not. But The Undertaker is like, he's number one with a bullet. And you know what? I'm not sure you could have given Kamala to anybody else, and they would have been able to make that gimmick. Kamala was, James Harris was the best Kamala that he could be. He was a perfect Kamala. you know, the gimmick, it sucked in a lot of ways. I mean, I wish they would have done something different. And by the way, I should mention that the Kamala character, the birth of the Kamala character, the original birth of that character, I mean, how Shoulders Torelli became Vinny V, Vinny also came out of a swamp. Although I don't think Kamala had a fish in his trousers.
Well,
but anyway,
he didn't come out of the swamp. He came out of the deepest.
He came out of the jungle.
Is that they always said the deepest, darkest jungles of Africa, which was actually when you saw those vignettes with him, Jerry Jarrett's backyard, and Kamala.
What a backyard!
Yes, and Kamala was painted up with what Jerry Lawler should. He was a far better Kamala than James Harris in the wrestling ring, at least. Sugar Bear Harris sucked as a wrestler. That was universal what people thought of him. They saw him in Memphis like one time. They said, all right, get out of here. But Lawler had an idea for him, which was this idea of Kamala, and whoever else helped to put this together, it was Lawler who would paint the stars and the moon because he saw it in National Geographic. So he did the same thing on Kamala, and it is a insanely racist gimmick that you could not pull off today without, I think, a huge wink and a nod. And if there was a huge wink and a nod, it doesn't work. The best part about Kamala was, there are the guys you could see through. There are guys who you knew even as a little kid was a wrestling gimmick. Kamala was just like he was in the category of the Bruiser Brodies, of the Road Warriors, of the Stan Hansons, of the one-man gangs. They were just guys that were larger-than-life personalities and characters that they fit in the wrestling, but it still made you kind of think, like, where is this guy from? What is this guy about? He ended up being Sugar Bear Harris from Mississippi, but you didn't know that. You thought he was Kamala, the Ugandan headhunter, and my wrestling fandom was a little different than yours in that I watched a lot more from a lot more different places. So for me growing up, Kamala was a ubiquitous character. He was in Memphis, and I didn't get to see much Memphis, but then they used those same vignettes and brought them to Mid-South. They used those same vignettes and brought them to World Class. And when Legends of World Class was on ESPN, and World Class was in syndication and also on ESPN with regular programming, he was on there seemingly all the time, feuding with the Von Erichs or getting into it with somebody. Then I remember him in 1985. It was a big deal at the Great American Bash. He was facing Magnum T.A. He was coming in as a guy to headhunt Magnum T.A. And the only thing I'll correct you on a little bit is the Kim Chi character, which Steve Lombardi would often play in the WWF, that was something that they came up with for Memphis, that he had a handler. He not only had a manager that would do the promos, he would have this gimmick that would be with him that wouldn't talk that could help him because J.J. Dillon was a Florida manager, so he wasn't coming into Memphis all that often except to do big dates. So they would use Kim Chi and whoever would play the role. I forget who they said would play Ken Wayne or whoever it would be that would do it, or Buddy Wayne down in Memphis. Steve Lombardi and other people would do it with the WWF. So it was an incredible gimmick, and he didn't have great wrestling matches. He didn't have to. He had to be body slammed by Andre the Giant and do a shake and you know, pretend like that was the worst thing that could ever happen, or choke on Hogan or you know, make Lawler bleed. He didn't have to do much, and he got the most out of it just with this incredible gimmick.
Steven here notes that Kamala was great, did not speak. Akbar did all the talking. He slammed Andre on a TV taping. I doubt it was easy. Kamala made it look easy. He was fantastic. Diabetes is an ongoing medical issue. He was one of the classics. Well, I can tell you one thing about slamming Andre. I don't want to say it was easy, but Andre did get slammed many times. And whatever you want to say about Andre at the very end when he could barely move and he was super heavy, that dude could work. And when he was young, he could work athletically. Is someone chopping down a tree outside? What's going on here? Anyway, when he was young, he could work athletically. And when he got older, as we've been watching on these Saturday night's main events, he couldn't work athletically so well. But my God, that guy's, his character, his ability to portray a giant, it was the greatest. But yes, I watched the footage yesterday of Kamala slamming Andre, and whoop, up and down he went.
Yeah.
It was very impressive.
Andre, get up there for it. And look, because it was a money-making promo, a deal for Andre. Like, Andre didn't, like, stud or whatever, but, like, mass superstar. You'd see him in angles, like, with money with these guys that, you know, and Kamala was, you know, I don't know how big he actually was. They billed him at 6'9", 400 pounds or whatever. But, I mean, that was a money-drawing thing. Andre had no problem getting up and moving for you when money was involved. And they did a hell of a thing. And that the Coliseum video opening was also legendary because it showed the reverse of Andre getting his revenge and slamming Kamala, and it was just, again, a great character that you couldn't do today in the same way. But, you know, I wouldn't want to go back and change the past on it either, because it was the greatest thing that happened. It was the greatest thing that happened to this guy, for sure. And as he got sicker later on in life, you know, tried to parlay some of that, and I wish he would have gotten his roses before he passed away, like Vader, like a lot of people from that WWE Hall of Fame that really could use the accolades and really would like that shine one more time.